Welcome back to Fit for Life with Karen. I can't believe that summer is almost over, but I'm raring to go. I've got some new things for you that I think you're going to find fun and interesting. Today we're going to talk about stress management, which is one of the basic fitness components anyway. I think you all know there are six of them, and stress management is kind of tacked on at the end, but it's really, really important because it's really, really bad for your health when you're stressed all the time. And in this day and age, it's kind of difficult not to be stressed. We have to work at it a little bit harder. Why is it important? The effects on the body are heart problems, high blood pressure, weakened immune system, memory loss. None of these things we can afford to have. We want to keep those at bay as long as possible. So the effects of stress on the body are very, very physical. It's mental and psychological, but it also is connected. It's very, very bad for your body, your physical body. Stress also accelerates aging, which we don't want. And aging can be stressful in itself. So it's kind of the way it works together, and it's something we have to work on. So we're going to do that today. Yes, what can we do about it? We can do aerobic exercise, and we're going to start with that today. You can get some quality sleep. I know you like that glass of wine before you go to bed, but and it'll make you sleepy, but also wakeful during the night. So don't drink two or three glasses at least, right? We want to eat well, and we want to eat from all the basic food groups. I think by now you know what those are. It's in the news all the time. Stay connected to family and friends. Don't be someone that hides away in your house all day. Get out there, meet people, take classes, take courses, go to your senior center. There's so much out there that will make you feel better and look better, and it really, really is helpful. It's good for your stress management. And how about laughter? That's important. I've been watching all the reruns of Raymond, and they really are funny. So shows like that can kind of keep us going, keep us uplifted. But today we're going to start with aerobic exercise, which is great for the mind and the body. It will relax you, make you feel better. All right. We're going to do Havana. And here we go. Side to side, easy stuff. Arms out, out, in, good. Out, out, this is so easy. Everyone can do this. But we're moving, we're burning calories, getting the heart rate up, forward. Just take a step forward, yes. Push. This is great. Push out, forward with arms and leg, forward again. Let's go to the side this time. Out, out, good, out. Bend your knees a little bit when you go out to the side, and back, good. Out to the side, one more time. Good. Now, reach, reach. Upper body, good. Reach. We're using your arms. It's always a better workout when you use both arms and legs. Good. Keep going. And five. And six. And seven. Stop right here and just bounce. Push. Two. How do your knees feel when you do this? Five. Six. Seven. Good. Again, one and two. And three, and four, and five. Push down. Now watch. Go up as you go down. Push those arms up. Three, four, and five, and six, and seven, eight. Now just kick out. One, and two, and three, and four, and five, six, and seven. Stop. Good. Again, arms out. Out and out. Kind of fun, isn't it? Easy to do. Got some good music here. Good. Now reach to the side. reach up, 5, 6, 7, to the side again, 1, 2, and 3, up, last one, good, now lift those knees up, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's do something for balance while we're up here. Front, side, back, and close. Front, side, back, and close again. And 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Now I'd like you to do it fast. Front, side, back, front, side, back. Front side back, front side back. Good. It's different when you do it fast, isn't it? Side back and stop. Good job. All right, let's rest just for a couple of seconds here. Grab your water. Always have your water with you. Really important too. Everything's important. Cheers. Good. Now, let's do some stretching. We've warmed up those muscles a little bit. Wonderful. You just lift that leg right up. You can do it under here, hands here, as long as you have good knees and you're not having problems. Bring that leg right in. Feel a nice stretch in your lower back. I do this one every single day, and I do it in the morning in bed, lying down, and my back always feels better. So just pull that knee in, great. And then I'm going to do the other side. Try to hold for at least 10 seconds. You can do a little longer if you want to. Good, pull that knee right in, great. Can you feel it there in your lower back, the lumbar area? It's great, it's a great stretch. Legs straight out. Now just bring those toes back towards your body. I'm going to sit up nice and straight, back away from the back of the chair. Point the toes, flex the feet back. So it's point and flex, point and flex, point. Good. Keep going. We'll say this is 5, 6, 7, 8. And one of the very first things that I do for my morning exercises is to circle the feet. So you'll gain some flexibility there in your ankle when you're stepping off a curb or even walking or stepping up. You want to make sure that that ankle is flexible just in case you do lose your balance a little bit. Let's try the other leg. Just make a circle. I usually do 8 of everything, sometimes 10. And then we'll go the other way. Wonderful. Okay, now leg out straight. Just lift it up and bounce it. 1, 2, and 3, and 4. So you're stretching the back of the leg a little bit. Your hamstrings especially. Let's try the other side. Flex that foot and bounce it. 1, so you're strengthening your quads and stretching underneath the leg just a little bit. And it's easy to do, and it's easier to do lying down, actually. So this is part of the bed exercises I do before I even get up. I have exercised. All right, now come forward in your chair just a little bit. We're going to stretch the spine again by just dropping forward. Open your feet a little bit. If you want, you can grab your ankles and keep your head up. Don't ever have to drop your head down like that. For some people, that's a problem. So we're stretching that spine again. Now we're extending up. Grab your wrist, pull that arm right up. There you go. Pull it up and pull it up. So we're extending the spine. We were just flexing, now we're extending. You know, you've done this before, I know you have. Bring those arms down. Now we're gonna do a little spinal rotation. And you're just gonna bring your arms up and turn slowly. If you want, you can take this hand in the front, put it on the arm of the chair and kind of pull yourself around. It feels really good. It's a good stretch. And now come back to center. This hand goes right here on the chair, and you're going to turn. How does that feel? One side will be a little better than the other, of course. And then we'll come back slowly. The spine can also bend, so let's do that one. And if you've been away from your exercise this summer, you'll recognize some of the things that we're doing now. So let's take this hand, cross it over. Your free arm goes up, up, and up again. And then we're going to do a nice bend here. Make sure you don't do that. That's not a stretch. Reach up straight to the side of the corner. And then we're going to stretch, switch arms, reach up, and a nice bend up to the sky. Good. How does that feel? Wow, that feels wonderful. So we're getting a lot of stretching with the upper body and the lower body too. I'd like to try one more for the lower body. Just reach underneath this time and lift that leg up and see how far up you can get your leg. You can do what you want with your foot, but try to lift that leg right up. Good. And then the other side. And I have a new exercise for you. While you're here, again, this could be lying down also, just lift and then let the leg fall down. So lift and fall and lift. And what that does is it helps that synovial fluid in your joint to loosen up a bit, thin out a little bit. So if you're having knee problems, especially climbing stairs, this is good to lubricate the knee. Again, I do it lying down, so my legs are straight up, and then I bend up and down. So it's this kind of a movement. I don't know if you heard that click in there. And I try to do it at least 15 times, maybe 20 times. It has helped. So sometimes it's just a matter of that fluid being too stiff and sticky in the morning, and then we can loosen that up a little bit with exercise. So I found that to be really helpful. So let's sit back a little bit more. One leg out straight, flexing that foot back away from the chair and out to the side. Now, if you have an arm on your chair, this will inhibit or stop that out to the side movement, but just do what you can do. Six, we'll say seven, and this is good for the hip. Straight out, flex that foot and out to the side. One and two, nice and tall. You're tightening this area, your abdomen. And five. So we're stretching, 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 stretching. Yes, wonderful. So I'm going to have another sip of my water. And I thought, again, for stretching, we're going to do some yoga today. Not a lot, but a little bit. Much easier just to take the darn cap right off. Now, I don't know if any of you have taken a yoga course this summer or plan to do it. I suggest it. Yoga is great for everything. It's good for balance, strength, flexibility. It's meditative. It's wonderful. Good for everything. All right, the first thing we're going to do is say namaste, which is a greeting, a salutation, just a hello. And just noticing everyone else that's with you in your class, it's kind of saying hello to them. So sometimes we end with namaste also. So just keep that in mind. First thing I'd like to do is just drop the head down. We're just going to stretch the neck a little bit and your shoulders and your upper back, looking up at the ceiling, looking straight ahead. And then you're going to turn that head and hold it for a little while. Just a few seconds, and then we'll go back to the other side. Try to maintain your posture if you can. And then we're going to do an ear drop, just dropping the ear down to the shoulder. Good. And then down to the other side. Now, do you hear anything in there? Sometimes it gets a little crunchy. You might hear some sounds. As long as you're not in pain, you should be okay. If it was really severe, you would talk to your doctor or your physical therapist. All right, wonderful. Let's take each finger to the thumb, just to do a little bit for the hands today also. Each finger to the thumb, circle those hands a few times, and then we'll go back. Now, a favorite exercise of mine is the yoga cat. It's great for posture, great for all over stretching, your upper body especially. Hands on your knees, just pull yourself up nice and straight. Pull those shoulders down. We're just gonna look up at the ceiling. Just think of arching your back a tiny bit, as long as that doesn't feel uncomfortable. All right, now we're gonna drop the head down. We're gonna do the opposite. Lift the shoulders up, round your back, and just drop the head down. Pull that abdomen in just a little bit. Now, what you're gonna do is you're gonna breathe up as you pull yourself up. So the head comes up first, shoulders come down next, and a little bit of an arching there in the back, looking up at the ceiling. Good, good. So how does that feel? Let's try another one. You know how cats do this sometimes, so we're kind of imitating a cat. All right, let's breathe up through the nose again. Shoulders come down, looking up, holding that breath for a couple of seconds, breathing out through your mouth, out, out, and round your back. So we're just doing the opposite of that straight back we just had. And then you're gonna bring yourself up. Wonderful. Now what I'd like to do is have you turn both knees on an angle. Come forward in your chair. We're gonna put one leg. There's a lot of this kind of movement with the knees in yoga. So we're just doing it in the chair because we do chair exercise mostly. We don't get down on the floor. We usually don't stand up. We may at some point, but most of what we do is in the chair. So you're gonna reach down, pull that leg back a little bit. If you can, let go of the arm of the chair and reach forward and pull back at the same time. So you're getting a full body stretch here. And it's a nice movement and it looks like yoga to me. And then you'll come down slowly. Try to hold all of these longer when you do it on your own. So now we're going to stretch the back of the upper leg. So bring that leg forward. It's straight. Toes are up, nice and tall, shoulders down. And you can hold on if you want to. Come forward with a straight back. Don't round over like this. Keep the back straight. Good. And come forward. How does that feel? Feels pretty good to me. Now we have two sides. So we have to do the other side. So I'm going to turn away to the other side. Don't leave this leg over here anywhere. It should be parallel. The thighs should be parallel. Good. Sitting up nice and straight. The outside leg, the leg closest to me, goes back first. Now, if you could not pick your leg up, maybe you could pick up the pant leg, especially if you're wearing a stretchy pant. But I'm going to reach down and lift and pull back. I can go a little bit farther back on this side. So reaching forward and back at the same time is really a full body stretch. It's really good for you. So I'm really fond of this stretch. Nice and tall. Good. Let that foot down and then bring that same leg, that outside leg forward. Again, watching your posture. Great. Keep your back straight. So all of this exercise, especially if it's done properly and slowly and with the yoga breath, yoga is great for stress management. Keep that in mind. So, and it's usually quiet. We have some nice music. We're gonna come forward. All right, now if you wanted to, you could round over and just slide that hand down as far as you want to and touch your toe, but this is a really good full body overall stretch. Open those feet a little bit. Let's come forward, keeping the head up if you have to. Great. You can grab your ankles as we did before, or just touch the floor. Yes, I can get down there with a little effort. I haven't done this movement for a while myself. Do the best you can. Hands on your knees. Pull yourself up nice and straight and pull those shoulders down. And you really look like a yogi, don't you? We can bring those feet in a little bit. Let's bring the arms up, up, up. Good. Great. See if you can go back just a little bit. And then come forward. And you can separate the hands and just drop down. Keep that head up, holding on, and you'll be able to go down a little bit easier this time. You really will. That's great. And then we'll come back up slowly. Let's do this. Pull that leg right up. If you're not comfortable here, you can put this right down here. This is called the pigeon. It's usually done on the floor. So you're lying down. The leg underneath is usually straight back, but we're doing our version of it so we can get some benefit here. This is good for the hip. Very gently push down. You're not going to be able to push down very much, especially if you have some arthritis in that hip. But I find it keeps me limber, because if, you know, something gives you even a little bit of discomfort, we tend not to do it. In most cases, especially with yoga, you need to do a little bit, as long as it isn't excruciating pain. And you can always ask your doctor or your therapist or your personal trainer, if you use working with a personal trainer, but she will tell you all these things too. Good, we're gonna hold that for a few seconds, all right. Now let's go back to the other side. Just bring that leg up. Now this one doesn't go down as much, so I'll have to work on that. So watch your posture, very gently inside of your knee if you can, even if it's an eighth of an inch, just to open up that hip area just a little bit. Good. So we're doing a lot of little things. And remember what I said, this is all for your relaxation, meditation, which is part of stress management. We have to learn to manage our stress. It's a very complex world out there, isn't it? All right. So how are you feeling? I hope you're feeling good. I'm going to sit back. What I'd like to do now is just practice the yoga breath a little bit. Hands on the knees. Let's breathe up together, up through the nose. Holding, and then exhaling. And the body cannot experience stress and relaxation at the same time. So if you're doing your breathing, it is going to help with your stress, but you have to do it more than once. So just keep that in mind. Let's breathe up again. Hold for two. Exhale through your mouth if you can. Drop the chin down. Right, you can round your back here. Again, this is the yoga cat. And it's really great. We're just using the breath this time. Let's do one more breath together. Breathing up. Way up this time. Nice long breath. Holding that breath. And then exhaling through your mouth. Count, count. One, two, three, four, and five or six if you can do it. Again, make that exhalation just a little bit longer. Good, and we'll bring that head back up. Let's clasp the hands together, turn them over, stretch out, bring those arms up as much as you can, all the way up. Great. And then bring them down. Open your feet just a little bit. I'd like you to sit in a comfortable position. Just make sure you're comfortable. Slide forward a little bit in your chair. Heels down on the floor. Just move those feet back and forth. That will loosen up your legs a little bit. Just doing this is really quite relaxing, especially if you have your yoga music. So try to keep music on when you are exercising. It will help. It will give you more energy. With yoga, it should be more calming. But for the next minute or so, we're just going to sit and do nothing. And what I want you to think about is we're going to start with the yoga breath. When the thoughts start coming back in, because they will, it takes a while to really perfect yoga and meditation and doing it correctly and long enough for you to get the benefit of that nice relaxing feeling. It does work, but you have to do it more than once a week, okay? So let's take that first breath together all the way up. Hold that breath for two if you can. Exhale through your mouth. Good. Let your head drop down. Just relax. And just, you know, experience and feel how good this feels to truly relax your body. Turn your mind off. All these little things we think about and worry about usually don't happen. Most of them don't happen. So when you are stressed out, find a quiet place. Put on some nice music, and we're going to end. We're going to do the last minute together, and it's going to be perfect silence. I think some people are afraid of silence. We have to have noise all the time. So this is really, really important, and I hope you'll take a yoga course, do some reading on it, watch it online. And here we go. All right. I want to thank you all for tuning us in. Hope you got something out of what we did. And we'll see you next time. Bye for now.